Hi there. In one of my previous tips, I showed you guys how to make pipes in Cinema 4D using some simple techniques and a sweep NURBS object. In this tip, I'm going to expand on that a little bit. And the reason is, one of my viewers on YouTube actually asked me, well, he called me out on something I said in that previous video, where I said that if you were doing it in a production environment, you'd want to be more precise about your cuts. And so he threw it back to me and asked me, well, how would you do that? How would you be more precise about the cuts? So let's start by deactivating the sweep so we can see our points. And I'm just going to chamfer this one edge so that we can, this one point rather, so that we can see what's going on. So it's a curve now. And I can now zoom in on the area. And we can see that it looks fine. So if we turn on lines, we can see that there are a few lines here. And what the question exactly was is, how do we add another ring of edges right here and another ring of edges right there that are exactly the same distance apart? So if you're dealing with right angles, that's a pretty easy thing to accomplish. But if you have strange angles like this, it can be kind of tricky. So the reason I started off with this with these points is because the solution is actually to create a few circles, and that works best if you have these points in place. So I'm going to go to the top view and turn on snapping, and just make sure vertex snap is on, or spline point snap. I mean, this technique will also work in most versions of Cinema 4D. So I'm going to create a circle, and with snapping on, I should just be able to snap it right to the point. And then I'll scale it down. And then we can create an instance of the circle. And I'm just going to place it on the other point. And we just place a circle on every point that we want to measure. Now the cool part about this is the central point passes through the center of our circle. And that essentially makes each line a normal coming off the edge of the tangent of the circle. So the way it works when you really break it down is that you can select all these points, do your chamfer like you normally would, like we showed in the previous tutorial. So we've got a chamfer like that. And then you can actually, well, you can scale each circle so that it meets the points accurately, or if you wanted to be a little bit more tricky about it, you can just do the chamfer independently. So you would do one chamfer, and then you'd only do it so it meets the edge of the circle. You'd do another chamfer for the same effect, and you'd just continue like that. You don't have to. You can just use the circles. So for the sake of brevity, let's just do all of these at once. And we now have these circles that are all sort of spaced slightly differently from where the points are. But the good part is that they are all at the center of where they started. So what that means, I'm just going to convert these from instances to circles. What that means is that we can actually select one of these circles and scale it up until it hits those points. And it's sort of a central point that we can work from. So if we turn the sweep NURBS back on and go to wireframe mode, what we can actually do is select one of these circles and scale it up until it intersects that center right there where we know that point was. And we can basically just do that for each of these. So this one would need to be scaled down, as would this one. And this one right here. So if you're going to use differently sized circles like this, the math is going to be slightly harder in that you would have to manually add the distance. So if you wanted, let's try to find out how big this circle is. So these circles all have a radius of different dimensions at this point, but we want to increase the radius of each circle by a certain amount. So what we can do is we can select this first circle and you say 12.752, let's just say plus 10. Now it's 10 units larger, and we can do the same for all of these. So we just go to each circle and we just say plus 10. If you kept these instances, you could actually do this just using the scale tool. You can just scale the master circle up and all the other ones would follow. But in this case, we're just going to add 10 to each circle. And once we've done that, we can actually turn our sweep NURBS off. And now we have a new point adjacent to each of these points that already exists. That's basically 10 units more. So now we can just use our knife tool and cut, cut. And we can just go around cutting at the exact spot we want. And yes, this is kind of an abstract tip. So we can go around making these cuts, just like that. And if we turn our sweep back on, we can see that now, let's go back to the camera view, we can see that we actually have an extra loop of edges right where the circle is. So that's kind of a way to measure this using guides. There is another way, and this other way only works with Cinema 4DR 14. So I'll show you that really quickly. What you can do is you can use the guide tool. So again, I'm going to turn off the sweep NURB, so we just have the spline. I'll delete all these circles. And so we have our spline here, and we know that there are points on it. So if we use the guide tool, we see it snaps every time we hit a point. So a spline, and then vertex, vertex. So there's a vertex and there's a midpoint happening here. So if we go to the second vertex, we can actually just click and then we can drag along the spline. And then we can make it a square or whatever. But we can actually just do this for a couple of them. So I'm going to do this for this one too. And you can see it'll snap no matter what angle it's at. So that's really valuable to us. And once we're done, we have these two guide objects. Now I've done a bit of experimenting and I've found that what works the best, just going to bring these up to the zero level, or actually even better, I'm going to move them up to the level of the spline. So what I've found works best is when you switch these guides from plane to line, and then change it to spatial mode, and change it from infinite to segment. So this actually lets you set a uniform size, and the guides shoot out from that point. So let's say I wanted it to be 26. We can make them 26, and then we can come down to our spline, and we can use the knife tool to make a cut there and there. And then we can just move this and snap it to the end of the guide, changing the distance. So we know now that the distance between these two points and these two points is identical. So that's just a way to use the guides in Cinema 4DR 14 to accomplish the same thing. So it's just about creating an even spacing. Use some circles as a guide, some squares. Just use other objects which you can be sure of the size. And until next time, thanks for watching the tip.